Hello everyone, Sigmalator here. Welcome back to Silent Hill, the short message. Yesterday's episode brought up some stuff in me, so I had to split this in two. I'm pretty sure that this game is
An
hour. So this will probably be wrapping things up. But I needed to step away. But we are back now. So I'm guessing we're getting no more text messages there if the battery's out. No exit. Bad girl gets an empty plate. Delightful. Oh, swinging lights. That's always a good sign. It's all your fault. Okay.
This is all your fault.
Is that Anita's mother? Someone's crying over there. Probably Maya. Well, although Maya's dead. Nothing around here, okay. It's all your fault. Wait, did I kill Maya?
What?
Slut.
Who would do this?
Lots of crawling. I don't like it. Okay. Someone likes darts. That's not how you play that game, mate. Oh. Hi. Can I take one of these lights?
Wait, it's back on.
Okay. Children Who Turn Trauma into Tales, Solitude and Anxiety in Teenagers Part 2. All of the teenagers surveyed suffered from deep psychological issues caused by past experiences, and interestingly, all of them conceptualized those issues as grandiose stories of sorts. One girl placed herself in the role of a tragic hero, convincing herself she was at the mercy of an abusive stepmother, and that her loving real mother existed elsewhere. Another girl viewed her childhood scars as stigmata, believing these scars would bloom into beautiful cherry blossoms. Okay, so this is talking about Anita and Maya. These convenient tales in the face of extreme adversity are born out of a deep desire to escape unbearable pain and self-hatred. The greater the trauma, the more grandiose the story surrounding it. Let's see. Underdog. Alright, let's check out this painting.
How could somebody do this? Some people really have nothing better to do. Wait. I bet it was these guys.
Whoa, okay.
What's this?
All your fault. Oh, it's the ground's collapsed. Yeah, that's about right for Silent Hill. Anything else around here? No. Cool.
This is just like before.
Yeah, we're in a loop. It's very much like PT. So is Maya really dead? Why are you asking that? Please tell me. I still can't believe she's gone either. Wish it was a lie. She seemed perfectly fine before it happened. So Maya really is dead then, yeah? Anita, are you okay? You getting enough sleep? Kinda. I'm taking some really good meds. Meds are good, but what about therapy?
You're so good to me, but you're leaving me behind.
All she talked about was a book she read recently. Still, I feel guilty for what happened. Even if she didn't tell me anything, I should have known something was up.
Did Maya really not say anything? Like, at all?
So what'd you think of the book? The author killed themselves when they were young. Something beautiful. From something tragic. It's kind of enchanting, isn't it?
Not really.
I wonder what they were thinking right before they died. Anyway, I didn't think you'd share your thoughts in a letter. You really are shy, aren't you? I actually kind of like that, though. You write in a really flowery and passionate way. I can't wait to read more.
Oh, okay. Letters.
What was that? Did I miss something? If you want food, do what I say.
You want food? Do what I say.
In Japanese culture, there has long been a sense of beauty in sacrifice, with harakiri, killing oneself by slicing one's stomach, being a prime example. The idea was that by taking your own life, you symbolically purge the world of your transgressions and purify yourself. This concept can be confusing to many Westerners, with young people incorrectly assuming the Japanese yearn for a beautiful way to die. Modern Japanese people, however, do not view suicide in such a positive light anymore, and the life they value is not the biological variety, but rather a social one. where death is needed to protect that life. Yeah, we've read that one already, I think. Belief in the Witch of Kettenstad. Those who believe in the Witch of Kettenstad share many practices with modern Wiccans, such as praying for a bountiful harvest and goddess of worship. What sets the practice apart is its slightly blend of both Western and Eastern customs. As for what led to the mixing of customs, there is one rather creative theory. During the joint efforts of Japanese and German entrepreneurs and labourers in the 1930s to foster economic growth and prosperity, there was an exchange in cultural beliefs giving rise to the belief in witches. Cool.
Wonder what those guys are talking about. Fortune telling? A lot of people are getting into that, huh? You don't believe in that stuff? Well, I think there's something real about it. My great-grandmother was a fortune teller. I hear people here used to treat her like some sort of prophet. But they all eventually turned on my great-grandmother. Guess you can predict other people's futures. But not your own.
Tarot cards. No point predicting my future.
That's unnecessarily loud. Grim. This is all your fault. Everything. You're a heartless bitch. You stole my only friend, my place in this world, all of it. And you don't even care. I'm invisible to you. I fucking hate you. You're not talented. You're not special. You call those shit stains art. You came out of nowhere and ruined everything. Fuck off, fuck off, fuck off, fuck off. Wow. Get the fuck out of my life, you piece of shit freak. I think they might be mad at me. Deutschland Medical University School of Medicine Orientation. Dear incoming freshmen, welcome to Deutschland Medical University. Founded in 1709, DMU is one of Europe's oldest and most revered institutions. Its state-of-the-art research facilities eagerly await your arrival. Orientation details. When? September 24th, 2021, 11:30 to 1 o'clock. Wear School of Medicine Central Lecture Hall. Please wear a mask when attending.
This is for the college Amelie wants to go to.
Amelie! Okay, so that's how it's, you pronounce that. Hey, Anita, you got a minute? Sure, what's up? You seemed kind of out of it before. If something's bothering you, you can let me know. Thanks, but I'm fine. Sorry to bring it up. Don't want to pry. No, it's okay. I don't mind. Hey, we should go shopping together sometimes. I haven't left my house in what feels like forever. Plus, my brother's coming here. Alright, you okay? Yeah, just gonna try to avoid him as much as possible. So, shopping, yeah? We can find you something cute. No, I'm good. I'm not a fan of crowds. And nothing looks cute on me anyway. Stop talking like that. You're way too hard on yourself. You've got the looks. You just need to find the right outfit.
Too hard on myself, huh? Amelie's the only one who thinks that.
Oh, delightful. I had 7/23/2020. I haven't been able to study since my brother came back for Christmas break. He's nice and doesn't interrupt my studies or anything, but I can't stand him staring at me. Oh dear. I know he was probably just messing with me back then, but I've been scared of him ever since. It's made me hate any guy looking at me. I can't believe other girls walk around school and town showing so much skin. February 21st, 2021. I think I'm finally finding my study groove. My test scores are really good. I'm worried about how much my parents are fighting recently, though. They were yelling at each other again today. I asked Mum why, but she wouldn't say. May 11th. This is it. Test day tomorrow. Mum told me I should be proud of myself since I worked so hard, and so I'm feeling great. She's not my real mum, but I know she loves me, and I love her. Mum, I'm going to ace this test tomorrow for both you and Dad. North River. October 17th, 2020. I'm finally focused on my studies, so I think I might pull an all-nighter. It won't be good for my skin. I can just hear people calling me troll and nerd, but I don't care. I have to make it to college in the city. Mum and Dad are counting on me to do well. I'll make them proud by getting into my first choice. Alright, time to hit the books till morning. November 9th. Dad was talking today about how there was a plan to rebuild the town. They were going to use a bunch of funding from China to turn the town into something better, but everything got cancelled due to COVID. Sure, it would have been nice if it had gone through, but I just couldn't see it happening. Even if things had worked out, not in this place. It hasn't been special since I was little. There's nothing to do. The buildings are ancient. It's a dump. My future isn't here. It's in the city where college life is waiting for me. Everything's riding on my entrance exam next year. I have to get out before my brother comes back. Yeah, your brother sounds like a Robin. Stay home alone.
Stay home alone!
Average teenager's room. August 24th. I got some materials for my first choice in the mail today. I'm going to be a college freshman. I'm so happy. I still can't believe it. Mum, Dad, I'm going to study my ass off and be the best daughter ever. Thank you so much for everything. Mum and Dad are yelling at each other. They're talking about bankruptcy. Wasn't everything supposed to work out even without that rebuilding plan? So this means they're out of money, right? Does this mean I can't go to college? All that hard work was for nothing? No way, don't leave me. Mum, I can't stay here. I can't be stuck here with my brother. Mum just left. She told me to get out of the way. I have to get out of here. I want to disappear. But where would I go? This is all a bad dream. This is all a bad dream.
Amelie hated the way her brother looked at her. I bet she wants to leave to get away from all that.
I'm guessing, because it sounds like Amelie's adopted, that the brother is not her actual brother. Still creepy though. Young student found dead, possible suicide, September 25th, 2021. At around 10 a.m. on the 24th, a local resident reported seeing an 18-year-old female high school student fall from the roof of a Kittenstad apartment building. The girl was rushed to hospital but was pronounced dead 2 hours later. According to school staff, the girl was distraught over not being able to attend college due to troubles at home. No note or diary was found, but police still believe her death may be a suicide. So, Amelie's dead as well.
Amelie's not like this, though. Right?
I think you'll find everyone apart from you, well, maybe even you, everyone here is dead. But this is a Silent Hill adjacent town, so. Hold on. I'm not gonna go that way yet. That's where game wants me to go. And where game wants me to go in a certain direction, I will always go somewhere else first.
It's locked.
I heard you humming in there, Maya. Alright. Wish there was a sprint option. Because the only time you run in this game is when the game lets you. I don't do anything, it's just an automatic when that happens. That's a bit too bright for Silent Hill. What's going on? We're going back to high school.
School.
Now this reminds me of Outlast 2.
It won't open.
I guess he wants me to go where the noises are coming from, but I like to look at things and explore. Anything on there? No. Okay.
Dom!
God, kids are awful. Witch. No. Can't carry on going that way. Freak, no wonder nobody likes you at school. Oh, I fucking hated school.
What the hell?
Get out, you freak!
Slut, your heart's fucking
you're
weird.
A freak! Cut, you piece of shit!
I'm starting to think I might be hallucinating. I think you wanted to be more than friends though, didn't you? It's a coming. Just run. I heard you. I knew you were coming up that way. Jesus.
Stop.
Jesus. Oh, I see, we did a loop. What? The hell is going on? Oh, shit. Damn it! Wow, okay. I didn't even bother memorizing that route. I didn't think it was going to be another one of those.
Why are you chasing me?
Maybe I shouldn't go through those doors. Oh, hello, what's that? Okay, I just got completely turned around in here. This way? Oh, god damn it.
Are you gonna pick on me next?
Because I think that is a representation of Maya, or your guilt, or your guilt.
What did I do to deserve this?
I think you killed Maya. Find it. Find what? Find it. Just tell me what I'm looking for. Find it.
What the fuck am I supposed to find?
The truth? I don't know. Going to examine that, thank you. January 31st. I haven't really been in a good mood since this morning. I tried to lose myself in my graffiti, but I wasn't feeling it. Maybe it's because Mum and I argued this morning. Probably not. We've clashed before. I've known for a long time we value different things. Is it because my classmates tease me? I doubt it. They don't know me. They're just taking their issues out on someone. It's got to be because I lost that special person that the hope he gave me, right? And the hope he gave me, right? Why do I feel like this? I've never felt like this before.
This guy looks familiar.
Yeah, this is the one I wanted to re-look at before because it was only on there for a brief second. So maybe Maya had a crush on this dude.
They're hurt. Where are you going? Yeah, that's right. Amelie.
What's that? Oh, you like what you see? Come closer, then. Wait a sec. You two are from my class, Those glasses look good on you. Sorry, she's so cute. I couldn't help myself. Feel free to stop by anytime. You're always welcome.
Okay.
Maya only ever cared about Amelie.
Oh, so you were jealous.
She didn't see me. I was invisible to her.
I think I'm right. I think Anita killed Maya. Out of jealousy. Pregnancy test positive. Okay.
The girl in this picture is Amelie.
Oh, cool.
Impressions in a letter. Read it when you get home, okay?
So I need to find the letter. I'm guessing that was the last time Maya was alive.
Where was it?
Kettenstad, the town cursed by a witch, malicious magic to blame for city slump. Kettenstad continues to see a rapid decline in its population. The birth rate is at a mere 0.7, less than half of the German nation average, 1.6. Miscarriages are also at 31%, more than double the average of 15%. The economy is in shambles, and the once booming industrial city has failed to revitalize itself twice. A number of researchers studying the occult point to a witch of the cause of the economic downturn in Kettenstad. The witch was a Japanese woman who used her clairvoyance to influence economic development in the town in the 1930s. Researchers believe she was hunted down and killed. Before her death, she is believed to have placed a curse on the town, stemming its growth.
So, it is a curse. But why me? Why do I have to be cursed like this?
Find it. Tell me, is this your curse? Find it.
Find what in a place like this?
Guess I'd spare. See what I can find. The Witch Hunt of Kettenstad. In 1930s Germany, the town of Kettenstad attracted wealthy entrepreneurs and enjoyed a period of economic prosperity behind that success. Though it was supposedly a Japanese woman who used her clairvoyance and mystical powers to guide the entrepreneurs. She would come to be known as the Witch of the Far East and would be greatly respected by the German people. However, in 1947, the entrepreneurs suffered great losses. A large fire spread throughout their industrial parks, losing them the majority of their factories. witch of the Far East who was hospitalized jumped off the roof of the hospital and killed herself. The witches had been diagnosed with an unknown illness, and many believed the fires pushed her over the edge. Some citizens, however, claimed that a witch hunt was to blame. They argued the witch's rise to prominence angered the mayor's party, who used the chaos from the fires as a cover for murder. There is no evidence to support this claim, and many now view it as a mere conspiracy theory, but the mayor's party did manage to regain influence in the town after the witch's death. Since then, citizens have started to believe any stroke of bad luck is a result of the witch's curse.
A witch's curse? Is that why I saw what I did before?
Sapiens.
Looks like there's space for a book here. Wait, I think I know these.
It's in one of the lockers. Volume 2.
No way.
I still wait for you. Okay. Oh, good, a long, ominous hallway.
I've never seen Maya like that before.
Stop talking like that. You're alright, Anita? You left me on red, so I was worried. Sorry, I was just thinking about Maya. Not sure if you know this, but Maya was bullied at school. I know. But she said she was okay. I figured I shouldn't push the issue. Then it was too late. Why didn't she say anything before she died? I wish she had talked to me. Maybe she didn't see me as a friend.
That's not true. What?
Liar.
Maya's locker. No, it's not here. It wasn't here before either.
This one,
my locker.
Then?
Why is it locked? Is there something I don't want to see?
Probably. Color coded. I wonder. No. Anything around here? There has to be something I'm missing. Oh, I can bring the phone up. Okay, I didn't know I could do that. Okay, I'm missing something. That's locked. Ah! There's numbers jotted around. There's two on the wall there. Three. And they're color-coded as well. Oh, I think I know what it is. The color of the letters is the order of the numbers. So we've got two there. Blue two, red three. Yellow one. No. Red, yellow, blue. Red was 3, 1, 2. I just need to find the black number. I was going to say, why did the music stop? Oh, there. Zero.
I know what's inside. And I can't look away. Here it is. What's this letter? Was it inside the book?
Remember when I said I wanted to live like a cherry blossom? To be beautiful and dignified for a fleeting moment, simply by letting go of life. Daring to bloom, knowing it won't last. And so falling in vivid color. I wish I could live like that. I want to experience true beauty, if only for a moment. I met someone who made me feel different. He showed me a whole new world, gave me hope. I honestly thought he could help me find a new me. I felt it with all my heart. But people didn't understand us. Didn't want that from us. In the end, they took my hope from me. They took him away. People who can't achieve beauty seek comfort in others. They fear anyone different, hate them, try to tear them down. I can't take much more of this. I wish you and I could run away together. Amelie. Just me and you.
Maya. She was asking Amelie for help. But I just...
You hit the letter.
You have everything. You're way more talented than me. So, why? Why take Amelie from me, who acted like I wasn't even there? Amelie is my friend. She's mine! I only wanted to take her down a bit. She was taking Amelie away from me. Yeah. She wouldn't pay attention to me. How was I supposed to know she'd actually kill herself?
Yeah, thought so. Called it. You may not be directly responsible, as in you didn't murder her, but you pushed her over the edge. Oh, wonderful, one of these again. Just noticed the phone's glitching, didn't notice that before. Right, now we should be able to go forward. Yeah, there we go. Get juked! There's no way. There's no way. I did that perfectly. Unless I was meant to die.
I'm so sorry.
Alright. Let's try that again. Still behind me. Oh shit. Ah, that was a dead end, that's why. I think that's exactly what it is. This is your pyramid head.
Oh,
Well, I need to memorize the other routes. I need to get this in my head. What happened? The dead end changed.
Look at me!
Wait, stairs! Yes, there we go. Back to the roof. I did it. Damn. Is that the end of it? Oh no.
What? But I jumped off the building.
Twice. Apparently your punishment isn't over. Huh? Oh, there we are.
Even if I die, this doesn't end. How many times do I have to go through this?
Find it. Oh, so that wasn't the it we were supposed to find? How can I get you to forgive me? Please, Maya, tell me. Why won't you say anything? Because it's not Maya. Right, and on that note, I'm going to end this episode here. Thank you very much for taking the time to watch this, guys. If you liked it, like, subscribe, ding that bell. Sigmulator, this has been Silent Hill, the short message, and I'll catch you next time. Take care now.